In this video, we're going to talk about the practice science strategy, learning the big ideas. To help children prepare for kindergarten and engage in science learning, think about integrating big ideas of science into your learning activities. The big ideas are important because they're all around us and found in children's everyday lives. You can implement the big ideas in science by focusing on repeating patterns, cause and effect, structure and function, and stability and change. Let's talk about patterns first. Young children begin to recognize patterns in their own lives by exploring the characteristics of different things, such as types of animals, such as insects or mammals, plants, such as trees, grass, or shrubs, or materials, such as wood, rock, metal, or plastic. Support children's understanding of patterns as they explore similarities and differences among things or classify objects into groups based on similarities, such as smooth versus rough. Our next big idea is cause and effect. You can support children's understanding of cause and effect as they make predictions and explore how or why something happens. For example, can children make a prediction about what a seed needs to germinate or start to grow? Repeating patterns or events in their world that occur together with regularity allow for exploration of these cause-effect relationships, like how night and day happens as the sun rises and sets each day. Nadia noticed the children in her class showing interest in how roly-polies behaved. She asked the children in her classroom what they have observed about roly-polies so far. One little girl predicted simply picking up a roly-poly would cause it to bite her. She tested her prediction later while the class explored several types of bugs. Nadia asked the child if the bug she picked up bit her. Since none of the bugs she picked up bit her during their experiment, she concluded that simply picking up a bug would not always cause it to bite you. The more you talk about cause and effect, the more children will also look for and analyze these patterns by observing their world, for instance, the size of plants over time, or different kinds of insects. Another big idea is structure and function. Children can learn about how the world works by examining what things are made of and the shape of their parts. Think of the parts of our body and how we can use each to help us in our daily lives. The same analogy can be made for plants and animals. Finally, our last big idea is stability and change. Children can explore stability building objects with blocks. They can explore change by observing the growth of a plant or themselves. An important discussion of stability and change in young children is to recognize the importance of asking why something does and does not change. Drawing children's attention to these big ideas and using them for science learning will begin to come naturally as you learn to implement the process of science in your classroom. Now that you've learned about the practice science strategy, learning the big ideas, let's take a moment to review what we've learned. Think about integrating big ideas of science into your learning experiences. As you focus on preparing children for kindergarten, you can implement the big ideas in science by focusing on repeating patterns, cause and effect, structure and function, and stability and change. For more ideas, check out your PEAS teaching guide.